What did you realise about the band when you were faced with the idea that maybe it wouldn't continue?
What a great question. I thought it was going to be something else. I thought we were going to have to end the interview, man.
I thought the group was over.
If the internet gave birth to a band, it'd be this one. Brockhampton, a hip-hop boy group with 14 members. They met on a Kanye West fan forum in 2012 when this guy asked the question, anyone want to make a band?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Luckily for Kevin Abstract, they did. They all moved in together in Texas, and this year, with an EP and 3 albums behind them, they earned themselves a $15 million record deal.
My name is JD Smith. Brockhampton just signed the Carson.
This is the world's best, favorite, hardest working, all American boy band. This is Brockhampton in Australia.
We're in Sydney, Australia. It's my first time in Sydney.
It's one of those things where, like, you know, you go back to like your 12-year-old self and tell your 12-year-old self that in X amount of years you'll be in the middle of Australia, like performing sold-out shows. Like, I wouldn't believe you. This is like my first time really being out in the world.
It's pretty fucking surreal. I'm sorry. I don't know if I can cuss.
We're on the phone. Hey.
I remember like making music in the Woodlands, Texas, in San Marcos, Texas, in South Central Los Angeles with these cats right here. We were so hungry that like, we didn't, like a sensible person would pass by the house and think like, okay, these kids are like out their mind. They're never, like they're just gonna be broke their whole lives. You know what I'm saying? Like, because of the state we was living in. But good times came.
For us, it's like there's 12, 13, 14 of us involved in the creative process. It's like popcorn. Like everybody just like bounces off each other.
Nice shit, man. Y'all talented, we talented.
It's the right group of people, man. Everybody's like good-hearted. We care about each other. We care about the world, and we care about our friends and family. And I think that has like got us here, you know? So I guess it is fate.
Fate may have brought them together, but it's work ethic that's kept them going. They're a content-making machine. They've got their own music videos, documentaries, short films, and of course, music.
Hit a clap.
Why do you guys approach things so passionately, ferociously?
Because we can. And if you're not gonna do something with hunger, then why do it?
There's always so much creative input from everybody, so it's very easy to look at something creative and get different perspectives on it. Tell them boys don't run from us. I've been down too long, cousin. I've been down too long, brother. Tell the world I ain't scared nothing.
Tell the world I ain't scared jumping. Tell my boy I want to cripple on it. Tell the world stop tripping down. Tell the world I ain't scared of nothing. Tell the world I ain't scared of jumping.
What were you scared of before that you are no longer?
I used to be scared of being vulnerable and being honest and being upfront and transparent. When I write stuff, I don't really pay attention to what it means in the moment. It's all rooted in feeling. But that being said, there is intention there, and maybe like a few months later, I'll start to realize why I wrote what I wrote, and I'll figure the purpose out for it later on.
One thing Kevin raps about is something we've never really heard in mainstream hip-hop. Why you always rap about being gay? Cause not enough niggas rap and be gay.
Where I come from, niggas get called faggot and killed. So I'ma get hit from a nigga right here.
But sometimes you just, like, you have to think about what's missing and the genre you're a part of and try to bring something new to the table that could help people.
What do you think is missing?
I don't know. It depends, man. It depends on what angle you're looking at it from. Because if you're listening to the radio, you probably won't find any gay rappers. But if you're online, it's not that crazy. Just to make a change and to do what we feel is necessary in the hip hop community.
I got the motherfucking high score.
One member missing from the band is Amir Van. After allegations of sexual misconduct emerged against him, he denied the claims but admitted past wrongdoing. The band was shocked and said they were lied to by Amir. They asked him to leave the group.
I don't agree with anything Amir has admitted to. Having to deal with, like, family problems in front of the world is very difficult. And I'm sorry if, like, if this isn't enough.
I thought the group was over. And then I'm like, you know, we represent a lot. We mean a lot. Let's keep going.
After everything and what happened, I feel like it showed me that change is always going to happen and you have to learn to adapt and attack it.
I learned a lot about intention. Like, you can't forget the fact that, like, you are a human and everybody around you is human beings. So you have to treat them that way, because the moment that you don't is the moment that things will start to catch up to you.
Like, there's good times and bad times. You just figure it out when the bad times come.
How do you make sure that you talk to each other and keep things locked so that this has longevity?
Out of this whole timeline, people have, like, only begun to know who we are and care for, like, this much of it. And I remember all of this time still just as clearly as I remember this.
Like, I'm responsible for everyone here, and everyone here is responsible for me. So long as we work together.
You have to put your pride aside and look at a picture that's bigger than you many times. And the picture is something one man couldn't spend his whole lifetime on.